Hello students, hope you all are well at home and studying properly. So today we are going to start with the second lesson of history, that is from trade to territory. Fine, so please take out your books so that we could begin. So the first topic in this lesson is the arrival of the Europeans. So what we are actually going to study in this particular lesson is that how the people from Europe came to India and why they came to India, and how because of just trading they started to establish the territories and they started to capture India. Fine, so let's begin. So the first thing is to understand arrival of the Europeans. So when Europeans found they traveled, the voyagers and the travelers, when they came to the India, what they found? They found that the things in India are much easily available and are at very low prices. They thought of trading with India. So, if we take the example of Vasco da Gama, you must have heard his name. Fine. He traveled from the sea route. And when he came to India, what he found? That the peppers were at very low prices in India. That means to say, when he compared the prices of pepper, he found that it is 1/26th part of the other places. Fine. So, what he thought of just taking those peppers and selling it in the European countries and doing the trade. So, in this manner, he started his trade, and not only he, the other trading companies, the other companies also did the same. And what were the other attractions in India? What were the other things which they found, with which they could trade with India? The other things were the cotton textiles, with good quality of cotton, and then the indigo, which helped them for dyeing the clothes, then the saltpeter that is used for making the gunpowders. Fine, so all these things were easily and were present in very low prices in India. That is why the European countries started trading with India. They came with the trading companies in India. Fine, so especially the four countries which came for trading in India were the Portuguese, the Dutch, the French and the British. Although there were other more countries who came for small scale industries, or who came with the small scale industries for the lesser period of time, but these were the main countries who came in India to trade with India, and then slowly they also tried to make the territories. Fine. So the first one which we are going to study is European settings foothold in India is the Portuguese. How the Portuguese set their footholds in India. So the Portuguese were the first one to get into the trade, and they realized at the first that trading with India is going to give many advantages to them. Fine. So they started their trade from Cochin, Daman and Goa, and from there they started their trade. Although they had to also get into the fights with the Arabs, because they were already trading from these areas, but they were also benefited. They also got the benefit because of the fights that were there present in India. The rivalries between the Indian states gave them benefit for their trades, and then slowly they also started to make the forts where they used to trade to settle themselves. Fine, but then they did not expanded much from these areas to other areas, and then slowly they came to the end in 1580 CE. Fine, then came the Dutch. The Dutch established their trading centers in Ahmedabad, in Surat, in Agra, that is in UP, then Patna in Bihar, and many places. And mainly they traded for cotton, for silk, for indigo, for opium, and they were doing the good trade, but then in the middle of 18th century they were wiped off by the British. Fine. Now the next we are going to study about the French, how they started to trade in India. The first factory of the French was established in 1667 in Pontiac. From there they tried to expand their trading from India, and they also wanted to have the supremacy on the British. The governor of Pondicherry, Dupleix, wanted to make himself so strong that they could be superior than the British. Fine, but this could not happen, and the British did. Last one, but not the least, is the British, whom you have already heard about, that they were the traders who came to India and they stayed in India for the very long period of time. Fine. So when there was the Industrial Revolution, then the need of raw material, the need of finished goods increased a lot. Fine. And with the increase of these things, there was the increase in competition as well. Fine. So many European countries were in competition, and many companies were there to compete with each other for trading in India. Fine. So this was the condition at that time when the Queen Elizabeth I gave the East India Company a right so that they could easily come to India and they could trade from India without any competition from any other companies. Fine. But this, so the charter that was awarded to the East India Company by Queen Elizabeth I gave them the right to trade in East, but this did not help them from stopping the other European countries to trade. Fine. So there were also many other countries from Europe who were wanting to trade with India. So there was still the competition in India. Fine. So to end up this competition, what they used to do? The companies used to tried to stop the other companies from trading by any manner they could, by stopping their ships, by fighting with each other, and many other things. Fine. So these rivalries caused them to make the forts, so that wherever they are trading, from wherever point they are trading, wherever they are settling, they could not get harmed by the other companies or by the other countries. Fine. So what they started to make the forts in India. Fine. The Britishers started to make the forts in India, but then again these making of forts and then fighting with the other countries, bringing the armies from the Britain, caused them the loss in their profits which they were getting. Fine. Now to end up this, what they needed? To end up the competition. But this was not happening. Why? Because the other countries were also very much eager to trade with India. Fine. And on the other hand, when they were making the forts, the Nawabs in India were against them, because they were trying to make the forts in India without their permission. Fine. So they were against them, and then again there also was the situation of conflict and rivalries. Fine. So this was the condition when British started trading in India. Then, so please go through this part of the lesson properly, and we will meet in the next video. Till then, revise and study hard. Thank you.